The name of this piece is called The Beautiful Bird Revealing the Unknown to a Pair of Lovers. This piece is by Joan Muir, a Spanish painter. This piece is classified as modern art and surrealism. Through psychoanalysis, cultural studies, we can better understand this painting by Joan. Before we get into the critical analysis of this painting, first we must understand what is surrealism. Surrealism began in the 1920s. Surrealism can be better explained as an art movement that channeled the unconscious to unlock the powers of one's imagination. It was highly influenced by the Dada movement. The Dada movement was founded by Hugo Ball, Penny, Hans Arp, Christian Cesara, Marcel Janco, and Richard Heisenberg. It was a movement that arose as a reaction to World War I and the nationalism that many thought had led to the war. The Dada movement wasn't necessarily just paintings, but also all forms of art such as literature, poetry, sculpture, and photography. The Dada movement basically pioneered surrealism. Surrealists lived by one rule, which was not to accept an idea or image that can give away a rational or psychological or cultural explanation. A good example would be Fountain by Marcel Duchamp, where he decided to use a ready-made object and present it as his own art piece. What he did was grab a urinal, flip it upside down, and sign with a made-up name. Many artists felt like it was a mockery. The Beautiful Bird Revealing the Unknown to a Pair of Lovers is one of the 23 paintings of a series called The Constellation that are made of gouache, charcoal, and oil wash on paper by Joan Muir, located at the Museum of Modern Art in New York. Miró was a man of few words. He said he liked to honor his name, Miró, which means looker in French. All of his art pieces are all titled in French. He said French was the written language of his intellect. Miró explained to a friend in a letter he wrote how he got the idea of his collection. He said, "I had always enjoyed looking out of the windows at night and seeing the sky and the stars and the moon. But now we aren't allowed to do this anymore. So I painted the windows blue and I took my brushes and painted. And that was the beginning of the constellation." After completing the first 10 pieces of his collection, Miró and his family moved to Palma, Mallorca, where later on he completed the next 10. Miró later on moved to Barcelona, where he finished the rest of his collection from the constellation. It wasn't until after the war that Miró got international recognition and got invited to display his work at the Museum of Modern Art in New York City in 1945. 20th century artist and art, quoted Joan Miró. He said, "The speckles of the sky overwhelms me. I'm overwhelmed when I see an immense sky, the crescents of the moon, or the sun. There, in my pictures, tiny forms in huge empty spaces. Empty spaces, empty horizons, empty plains. Everything which is bare has always greatly impressed me." In The Beautiful Bird Revealing the Unknown to the Pair of Lovers, there is a lot of repetition of shapes and symbols all throughout the painting. In the constellation, stars are aligned and create figures such as the Little Dipper. In Miró's painting, he has lines that intersect many of the shapes and symbols, connecting them and allowing the viewer's eyes to travel all throughout the painting. Just like in the actual constellations, the lines that connect the shapes in Miró's painting create unknown figures. The figures are left unidentified so the viewer could have their own interpretation of what they see. Through psychoanalysis, we could see how Miró's life really impacted his artwork. For example, in The Ladder of Escape, he created in 1939, right as World War II began. He felt trapped and just wanted to escape. His pieces were the embodiment of how he was feeling at the time. Through psychoanalysis, we can see how living in Varangavaya, France, impacted this painting. Since the village where he lived had lots of blackouts and allowed him to see a very starry sky, something we don't see in the city, Miró was able to embody the appearance of a complex constellation in the night sky from the solid background to the repetition of symbols and shapes all throughout his painting.
For cultural studies, we witnessed how the traveling that Miró did impacted and influenced many of his paintings.
For my art piece, I decided to use charcoal and color pencils. I decided to draw the first thing that came to mind with the word constellation. Since I live in the city of Chicago, I can't see many stars due to all the city lights. The night sky reminds me of summer nights going to arcade bars and playing tech. The yellow circles represent street lights that light up the streets of Chicago at night, and the trail that Pac-Man eats. My Pac-Man is purple because it's one of my favorite colors. Unlike in the video game, he's yellow. The blue bars represent streets and the paths where Pac-Man goes through the maze. The black space is the empty night sky that we see in the city of Chicago. The beautiful bird revealing the unknown to a pair of lovers mimics the appearance of a complex constellation in the night sky. From its solid background that emphasizes the simplicity of forms and lines to its reduced color palette.